first contacted by Mike Greer. You bought in, obviously.
Yeah.
Why?
You know, for me, I wanted to take the next step as a player in my career. I think in my 2.5, 3 years in Minnesota, I've shown I can play that fourth line role. It was a lot of north south and dumping pucks and chasing pucks. And for me, it was about gaining confidence as a player and showing that, especially offensively, I got a lot more to give and getting some more leash by the coaching staff to try something. Even, you know, sometimes you fail, you make a mistake, to not be afraid that, you know, your ice time's gonna get cut short or stuff like that. So I felt like I was gonna get the chance to do that here, trying to bring certain values off the ice that are gonna help this organization be successful again. You know, trying to be a pro. What does that mean every day when you show up to the rink, when you show up to practices? How do you conduct yourself with the staff? And there's gonna be a lot of turnaround here. Probably not just this year, realistically. A lot of young players coming in, and I kind of want to be a bit of a beacon for those guys to look to, and especially off the ice, to show them that it's a lot of hard work that goes into playing an 82-game season and being a full-time NHL player. That's I think, the only way we're going to turn this around.
Well, I want to talk more about that, because you've already gained a reputation for being one of the hardest workers. First on the ice, first off, you participate in all the workouts. I know you're really intent on your recovery, on your training. What's your philosophy?
I think for me, at the end of the day, it's about preparation, feeling prepared for a game. There's a lot of different aspects that go into the game, and as an individual, you can't always control most of the stuff. You can't control realistically. You can only control what you do day in and day out. And sometimes you prepare and you do all the right things, and at the end of the day, you maybe not have the best game in the world, but then I can at least go home, or after the game, I can look in the mirror and honestly tell myself I did everything I could to prepare, and then I can sleep at night. And so for me, that's the best feeling.
So we know kind of how the rest of it goes, and you end up in Colorado. We know what happened there. You're about to meet them for the first time, which also means I think you're getting a ring.
Yeah.
I mean, are you, do you have butterflies? Like, what do you think that's gonna feel like?
Yeah, it's gonna be a special moment after the game. There was 4 months there that I'll never forget. The intensity and the stress on the body and the mind was absolutely incredible. Sometimes when I look back at the pictures or some video clips, it's pretty amazing the amount of work that goes into that, and how many highs and lows you go through. And then you're so close, and then you lose another game in the finals, and you feel like it's about to slip away when you're so close. And I always felt like those 48 hours between games feels like an eternity. It felt like an eternity. It's like you kind of want to just jump right back in and make it right. And those 48 hours, you don't barely get any sleep. It's so stressful. And then the moment when it finally happened is so much weight falling off your shoulders. And it's a very, very unique feeling. It's hard to describe.
What are your goals here?
I think as an organization, it's why I want to be part of the turnaround here. Certainly winning a Stanley Cup gives me some peace during stretches where we struggle as a team and don't have team success. You know, I'm not gonna lie, it's nice to be able to look back on that and have that in your back pocket, and kind of fuels you, gives you a little bit of fire. And also knowing that Colorado as an organization, for example, they were there at one point. I think you look at where they were in, I think, 2016, when they had, I think they were the worst team in the league, if I'm not mistaken. One of the worst. I think they had like 40 points. So I'm going to turn 28 soon, so I still have a lot of years, hopefully, left in this league. And I've had a lot of good talks with coaches and management here. And like I said before, I expressed my willingness and desire to be a big building block in what we're trying to do here.
Well, I have no doubt that is true and will be true for a while. So Nico, thanks for this.
Thank you.